Hey, what's up? This is Chris.
This is also Chris from Half Me.
And we're at Summer Breeze with Total Rock.
Or of Total Rock at Summer Breeze. Super excited, and I'm already half Chris. I'm with Chris and Chris of Half Me. How are you guys doing? Thank you very much for joining me.
Hey man, thank you so much for having us. It's amazing. I'm good, dude.
I'm having a blast here at Summer Breeze, so we're excited to be here, yeah.
Yeah, well, you're gonna sweat a bit more when you take the stage in about 2 hours, I think. Celebrating the release of Soma, your debut album that was released in February. Touches on some heavy stuff, a really intense story of madness and losing faith in the world, I guess, in society. Touches on anything that's dark in our reality right now. I'll try and take it the other way. What was the best part of the release? Signing to a rising empire, recording, doing some shows, the great reviews that you got, so the feedback. What's the best memory that in many years from now, when somebody says Soma, you're gonna go back to that memory?
Yeah, I mean, you've said it already. It's basically the whole world reacting to the album. Like, people just dig in the shit. Like, they fuck with it, and so do we. So I think that's something that I can definitely see myself in a couple of years looking back on it and being like, damn, we made that, you know?
But was there a specific event?
Not really. I mean, a lot of stuff already happened, and I'm assuming there's, like, a lot of stuff that's scheduled to happen like today, and yeah, I can't just pin it down to one event, but just the whole thing in its entirety. It's just extremely sick to see that, like, people just apparently like our stuff.
I don't know why you used the word apparently, but yeah, we like it.
It looks like it. So that makes me happy.
Yeah, it's basically, I think for me it was like the album release itself, like after months of sweating blood and shit into this album, being able to finally release it, and then like the whole world reacting to it, like from across the pond and stuff. That was pretty neat.
Well, it's funny how all those memories, great memories, created something so dark. We're going to touch on that in a second, but I love that after getting to know you through the music, I expect two kind of dark ghouls in blacks, no smiles, and I already love the smiles. I cannot wait to see you guys on stage. Another thing that I learned about the production is that everything was DIY, made by yourself. And on one hand, you got great reviews. On the other hand, growing, trying to delegate more, but still keep control. What's the future? Are you gonna still stick to that DIY mentality?
I think, like, starting with doing it all by yourself helps a lot in knowing what you want, what you really are aiming for. And when you then get external people into your production process, it really helps to, like, really know your shit. We worked with some people on the album, but we would like incorporate more people for the next album, get more creative juice and all together to create something new. But doing a DIY was a pain in the ass, but it also was like a really big learning process, and it helps to mold like the whole thing that Half Me has become.
Yeah, but also I want to shout out the whole team, because there's been a lot of people involved, like just so many people that had their say in anything, or just gave us feedback, or just listened to the whole thing and said, yep, that's it. Like, that stuff helps immensely, and just having those people in the team really just kind of, like, it feels like expanding from your own sort of starting point, which was DIY. And yeah, so that's to me, like, it's fucking mind-blowing that people cling on to something you create, you know? Yeah.
Again, I love it, and I cannot wait to see where it takes you guys in the future. If you've done it kind of by yourself, almost completely, with some help, but with some feedback, but it's the band's work. So I cannot wait to see what happens in the future when you even expand it more. As I already hinted, the themes are dark, so let's dive in. I picked up on some nihilism, and even the name of the album, Soma, I've not seen any quotes by the band relating it to that content, but the film Brave New World also uses the drug Soma that suppresses religion. In that book film, the society doesn't have religion. It doesn't exist there. It's not that they're against it. It just, it doesn't exist. So, and again, I know that the band said that it's not your story. The character in the album is not you guys. But still, there's a say about religion there, or is it just me seeing it?
Yeah, as well, yeah. Like, there's, I think the album touches on a whole variety of like topics, and I think that basically just stems from the idea that there's literally so much pain in the world, and also from the fact that I personally, like, I don't feel all of the pain. I don't feel repressed, you know. Like, there's people suffering right now, and it's really hard to put yourself in the shoes of someone else. And I think that's also why we've like dug into this variety of topics, and also going at it from this storytelling angle. So sort of, yeah, just having a character go through that shit, and which is also like a good thing in that sense, because our bassist, who actually, like, he's what is he, like,
a psychologist,
like a therapist, and so he's experiencing a lot of real life, like just reality of other people who've been going through the mud, like eating shit for years and all that. And I mean, we live like relatively good, I would say. So yeah, just having that kind of perspective on different things. Yeah, that's basically a whole idea for me writing about so many different topics, that's, and then like gluing it all together.
And where does, again, religion touch into that story?
Yeah. No, go on, dude.
I mean, you're the lyricist.
I mean, so there's, so it's like kind of like a personal thing, because I'm not really, I'm acting like, kind of like anti-theistic, I would say. And yeah, I just see so much like pain and suffering, like going way too much into the extremes, but like basically look at the fucking Crusades back then, like they slaughtered people just for some, we don't know what it is. And so, like, that's definitely where I feel a lot of there's a German word for it. It's called Weltschmerz, world pain. Yeah, and a lot of that comes, like, to me, it comes from religion. Yeah, and just, like, sort of institutions that claim the absolute truth, which, at the end of the day, it's all perspective. There's, like, yeah.
Well, I can definitely understand where it's coming from, and now I kind of anchored it even more with your words.
Yeah.
Another topic that sometimes makes people more happy is love.
Yeah.
And it also comes into the album, and you touch on OLD, obsessive love disorder. So do you find the relation between love, romance, and madness as well? Is that also a negative thing in our world?
I mean, for the songs, as Chris already said, we had like little short stories for every single song, and we wanted to picture like different kinds of mental illnesses, and there's also the obsessive love disorder with OLD, and we wanted to like shine on the theme that love can be poisonous, love can be like just ego and just destructive. And that's just one story of the whole like collection or the portfolio of our mental illness topics. So yeah, that's totally it.
So are you guys romantic? Do you believe in soulmates?
I think yes. Yeah, I believe in soulmates. So.
Yeah, I'm going with yes.
Okay, so after all that darkness, metal can still be positive.
Oh hell yeah! But also like touching, like, let's just say on the topic of like OLD and like the song Black Light is about it, and I think in Hamburg there's a club, a nightclub or something, the Golden Glove, and that really inspired the whole idea, and also like stuff like Halloween, Michael Myers, like that kind of like stalking part of it. Like, it's really, I think when you're loving someone, it's really, and it, like, it can go to different points of extreme, you know, And I can imagine like people going crazy for that shit. I mean, that's why there's a thing called obsessive love disorder. So yeah, that's really the whole inspiration, I think, behind it.
Well, I went through the album and I tried to find some sort of a silver lining, a happy ending. And the ending, the final track, the title track, Half Me, I felt like it's the calmest one, at least part of it. So for me, it also felt like almost embracing madness, like finding peace and just losing it. Did I get it right, or am I, again, just throwing myself under the bus, just finding calm in my madness?
Absolutely. When we stitched together the songs we had with Soma, we had like Rave as an opening, which illustrates like the beginning of a mental illness, like noticing some things that don't seem right and don't feel right. And Half Me is kind of the end of the chapter, accepting like the chaos, accepting the chaos, the darkness within yourself. And we wanted to have like a contrast to that with having a calm song, like being the most with the most dark and most depressing topic. So like embracing the sadness and the darkness within yourself. So yeah, you were right.
So we touched on so many dark sides of humanity. Are you guys extroverts, introverts? How do you interact with fans, with the new fame, being out there with society? Are you positive? Are you scared?
Like, I'm just generally like a positive guy, but I'm at the same time like really shy. Yeah. So I think we're both pretty much introverted. But I always feel that when you like put yourself into the music and like write that down or like write the music, it brings out a part of you that is in you, you know? So it's like...
And here.
Yeah.
A place where you can all let it out,
just, it's kind of like venting music.
Well, I'm happy that it helped, and it helped us as well. Oh, yeah. Between enjoying some darkness or venting and relating to that, or maybe even opening our minds to people around us. So even if we don't relate to it directly, we know that it's there.
Yeah.
Another thing that is dividing the world over the last couple of weeks already is the new Barbie film. That supposedly on paper is the opposite of metal, yet I watched it, I loved it, I related to some things and saw things around me in a new way. So I loved what it does. It starts conversations around the world, annoys some people, and I think if they're annoyed, then they should get even more annoyed and they deserve it. Have you watched it? Do you have any opinion about the discussion? Do you understand why people get upset with it?
I haven't watched it yet, sorry.
I haven't watched it either, but my girlfriend watched it, and she said that I should watch it, and when I don't like support the things that are in the movie, I get in trouble. So I think the movie, what I heard, did a lot of good. It's good stuff, like for feminism and stuff, and for like the whole patriarchy. And yeah, but I haven't watched it yet, so I have to do this.
Well, I love the yet in it, that you guys are open to it and you're looking forward to learning from that. Yeah. But again, I would recommend as well. It's a great film and it will definitely start a conversation. Even if you don't like the film, I think you will appreciate some bits of it.
I'm definitely going to see it. In preparation for that, me and my girlfriend have started watching the super old Barbie animation movies. So I'm not kidding.
You're going all Marvel on it.
Kind of, yeah.
I love it. I love that you're dedicated. Let's talk about the future of the band. I know that sometimes bands dive into the concept idea, so every album's going to have a concept. Sometimes they do one and they realize how difficult that is. Are you guys talking about the future already? I know that the album was just released a couple of months ago. Are there talks about the future? Have you thought about concept or not concept, anything about the future we can already mention?
A little bit. Of course, we are working on it, and like with Soma, we had like a concept that we are not really digging ourselves a lot into the like topics, and we definitely want to have a more personal, a more like story-driven album with stories from us and what we've been through the last years and what really fucks us up, and we want to be more personal with the next album, like for lyrics and stuff.
So we should expect a song about Barbie and the entire universe.
Yes,
of course.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Love it. What else can we, where can we get more Soma? Are there tours planned, visits the UK, maybe more videos?
we just announced a full metal cruise with Wacken, where we are on a fucking yacht.
It's a fucking cruise ship.
Yeah, a fucking cruise ship going from Kiel to Stockholm to Helsinki, like over a weekend. And we have some couple more festivals coming up this year. We play at Corefest, we play at Next Step Festival, and also...
Let me just say, there are plans.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. We'll just leave it like that.
Okay, I'll accept the tease for now. My least favorite word in German is Geduld. Yeah. I don't have patience. I hate that word. And talking to bands, they always tease me, and I stay hanging on for more, but I love that. Guys, is there anything else you want to say to fans before we say goodbye?
Yeah, come to our shows, get some fist in your face when in the mosh pit, fuck yourself up, have some fun. Yeah, that's it.
Enjoy Soma.
Guys, Chris and Chris of Half Me, Soma is out there making waves, breaking brains, bringing people together. I love that. It was great talking to you. Thank you very much for your time. Have a great set, and I'll see you soon.
Thank you so much, man. Likewise.
Thank you.